Now I have to make a normal backpack again as well, because you need one of those when we're heroic again. At least I don't fail that one. 40% chance I can get that 6 out of 9, but I can't get a fucking 33% once in 5 tries. Oh, it's 5 ancient relics, 5 spirit capes, 5 of both backpacks just gone, wasted. And I can't even get it. I gotta do another. Honestly, at this point, I don't even know where these imbue stones are coming from. I just turned one Zenite into it, noticed Flubber had like 5 in his bank. Like, they just spawn out of thin air nowadays, so let's go ahead and see if Flubber can get his 4th stone in the account in 7 attempts. Very unlikely, he's already been pretty lucky. Even if we fail all of these, that's completely fair. And we do that, like I said, fair. We're at 3 out of 33 still, that's more or less on raid, so better luck next time, but nice to get all those stones though, for sure. Alright, so we're gonna have to trade Mr. Larry over here. Gaskets are, in fact, 1500 blood money each. This is gonna be a bit of an issue. What's the easiest way to even go about this? Just like this? Just enough inventory space to buy a bunch of them at once. Until the grand looting bag is filled, I guess. And then pick up the food and leave? Question mark? I don't fucking know, bro. I don't do this on a daily basis. Yeah, I think just doing it like that, not even bringing the food, should be fine. Don't get any announcements from this, unless someone coincidentally shows up. They're not even gonna know you're doing this. Alright, just got done exchanging them. It took a little while, I'm not gonna lie. Ty also did get like 100k more blood money from doing Lava Dragon dailies while I was running them. So we even got a few more. Total of 435 caskets. I think Falcon is the way to go. You know what, I'm even just gonna make a preset for that and just rush through them, because honestly I don't want to be here all day. None of you guys do, and at the end of the day it's about what we get from it, right? And on top of that, I want to open the log real quick for comparison's sake, boxes, because the caskets, I'm gonna take a screenshot of it just for myself, and maybe for after we open all of these so we can compare. Will we be able to get any lava pendants and maybe some gloves of silence? Actually, those would be really good. Need a total of 5 to enchant it, and then you get no longer any wilderness announcements from drops. So if you get like a rare drop from Callisto, Venonatus, that kind of stuff, it won't announce for you, so people won't know you're there, which is really good. Let's go ahead and rush through it. I'm not gonna commentate too much unless we see a rare, because otherwise I feel like it's gonna get a little too long. All right, here we go. Oh, what for? Blood pet box on like the first tree. I see. That is actually really cool. We'll open any we have at the end of it. Lava keys will be very, very nice as well. Very beneficial. That's the wrong preset. Oh, curse to handed sword. Nice rune points. Ten cursed shards is an announcement, apparently. Oops. Didn't mean to emote. One singular bag of tokens is an announcement, okay. There's a cursed hood. Cut onyx. Are those all log items? I can't even tell. The hood is a duplicate. Are you fucking kidding me? The sword is a duplicate. The box was new. My god, that's kind of tragic. A looting bag is an announcement. Under 25 lava feathers is an announcement. Looting bag ain't on the log either, bro. We've only got one slot so far. This is kind of sad. Another cursed key, also a duplicate, already have that on the log. What's that? Cursed helm? Cursed helm. That log? Nothing is log, bro. Why am I even checking it anymore at this point? Wow, some nice gloves, except it's not the right one. We need gloves of silence, not cursed ones. Another cursed helm? Fuck off. At this point, oh yes, there we go, lava pendant! Hey, but goddamn time! Oh, that really makes up for all the shit we pulled. Alright, last few inventories. Give me more log slots, please. Or more pendants, obviously. Last inventory, I didn't even... Oh, there's another pendant! Let's fucking go! We take those. Another curse to age.
Gloves of Silence! Oh my god, it's all coming together all of a sudden! Goddamn! Goddamn!
That's a really good inventory to end it off with. So we only saw one Gloves of Silence in all those caskets, but two pendants, that's really good. Two Cursed to Age, that's 5k rune coins. A bunch of junk, obviously. I don't know how to track all of that. Oh yeah, we also got this Bloodbat mystery box. Deathbed, please? Nope, never lucky. Restoration thingy my bob. Blood boxes. Yeah, I need a deathbed and a ranged berserker to finish that, so that's not happening. Still so many items I need. Cursed ropes. Dragon, two crest pieces, an orb, and a cursed blade. I got three 2Hs, but not a single normal blade. Okay. This should be another good amount of rune coins. We also got some donated mystery caskets. I don't know if you can get anything good from those, but we'll open that real quick. And then lava feathers. We should have accumulated a decent amount. 3.5k almost. And another 24 keys as well. So we might be able to pull something off of that as well. Who knows? Alright, so we do have a few more lava keys. I'm just gonna go ahead and use them, to be honest. Like 20, 26 or something? I don't even remember the exact number. I could trade in lava feathers for like another 60 plus keys. We actually have quite a few feathers in our entire group Ironman, if we include everyone. It's just that I don't like trading those in, because it's a little scary, I'm not gonna lie. It's in the middle of multi, and it's super deep wieldy, so you can't teleport out, obviously. So if you get caught there, you're just kind of fucked, like guaranteed death, basically. I'm not a huge fan of that, but we might have to do something with it. It's kind of a waste of just let them rot in the bank. I could at least take the risk and try to, yeah, what this guy is doing, except in way bigger amounts. May as well, I guess. Another 10 keys. Come on, show us something, please. Dragon Square Shield, not even a... I thought it was Dragon Fire Shield for a second, but it's not even that. Anything useful, please? King Lava Dragon Teleport, I mean, it's something. Any pendants for the boys, please? Wow, I'm getting fucking destroyed by these demons right now. Jesus, relax. Took off half my HP right there, man, damn. Lots of PKs showed up this time, so I'm not even gonna do those final four right now. It's just not worth it. May as well wait a bit and pick a better time for it. When you don't get ambushed by all those people. Oh, we've all successful looting, I would say. I mean, we got two more pendants right here. If we store those. If I do the lava fetish tomorrow, we might get a few more. I think we should have a bunch in the bank already, or in the vault. If I can find them somewhere. Oh, right there. Oh, we're at 10. We can get 5 more, just 5 more. We could get a second Shazy and I set. That would genuinely be a very big up. We are also discussing doing necks with 4 people in the near future. We don't exactly have 4 crest root sets, so I quickly want to go ahead and try something. So what I wanted to test here real quick, I don't have my workout yet. Basically, try and compare crest root with this setup. Now, crest root is gonna be better. That is not the test. I don't have a Bork. That's on Flubret. I guess we'll use an next pet for now. Let me go ahead and get Turmoil. Basically, the idea here is, could the fourth person use that setup I have in my inventory right now and still be pretty okay with it at next? That's kind of what I want to test here real quick. So, in Crest Root, this whole setup, my max hit would be with a Chasm Bow of 59, which is obviously 59, 59, 59, because it hits 3 times. Let me put it on Rapid as well. Turmoil is activated, maximum potted, obviously not Infernal and stuff. And then, with this setup, this should be quite interesting, we can max a 49. So it's only 10 lower, technically 30, because it hits 3 times. That's honestly not even that bad. How does it compare with a Grand Ring Eye? Yeah, Grand Ring Eye is dead ass, just better than the God Rings. I'm not a huge fan of that. I wish the God Rings were just best in slot if you have enough items, but so be it. Do the devouts even matter? I kind of felt that way, that the D-Hide boots don't actually count as one of the God items. If I switch to Chasm Gloves here... Wow, the braces don't count either. That is honestly a little shocking. Because normally this halo right here, boost accuracy and damage by 2.5% for each Ceridomen, Zamorak, or Gothic God items equipped. But I don't think it works for this one. I mean, it is a... Nah, 5 ranged strength is not a plus 3 max hit. It dead as doesn't give the boost for the halo. Without a fucking doubt. That's a little unfortunate. And then the Grand Ring Eye is also better than the Unholy Ring. But obviously we don't have that many, so he might have to use that. And the boots don't increase it either. I'm a little saddened by that, I'm not gonna lie. And one more interesting thing to try out real quick is the Abyssal Crossbow with Abyssal Gloves. Just to get a little bit of an idea on that, I guess I could use Grassroot Defouts. See what it can max. 100. It's not a bolt spec Brock and go, so let's wait a second, see if that goes off. Keep in mind, I don't have unyieldings and all of that on this pet right now, so there's always potential for more, but the Abyssal Crossbow can also hit twice on its own, and blah 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 blah. Well, there's a proc, it hit a 147, but I think it's the second bolt where it went off, so it doesn't show a higher max hit, maybe? Huh, I hit 147, but the max hit still said it was 100. Gonna have to hit it a little bit more. Oh, there we go. 162 is the max hit with the Zenite Bolt procking properly, and you can hit twice with it. But what is it actually without the gloves in comparison? Like an 8 max hit difference, probably even more on a Zenite Bolt spec. Might be a very very valid option for sure. If we switch to this without the crest root even. Oh, I'm not using Abyssal Gloves, but like that's significantly lower still. Okay, 142 and 88 without any kind of specs. 89 if fully potted. I know why it's so much lower. It's because I'm using a Ranging T. This is not a good for... That's not great for testing because all the other items, the Crest Root and shit, you know, gives ranged strength. This one gives this and this. And the ranging trimmed has like an effect where you increase your total ranged strength by 1/15th of your ranged strength bonus. But probably better to compare it with a Zealot. So let's do this real quick. Normal max hit is an 84 with this. Kind of bit on the low side, fair enough. And then with Crest Root, it's a 94. So a 10 max hit difference. I will probably be using Chasmquaker Gauntlets as well. Oh, no, of course not. Of course not. You would use Abyssal Gloves with the Abyssal Crossbow, no matter what gear you're using. 94 versus 84. It's still quite a bit lower. What about Unholy Ring? Should be the same, right? Plus 1 max hit. You do get a bunch of accuracy for it, which might count for something. Shouldn't hit 0 too often because of all the bonuses, but yeah, it might be an option. Like, we only have 3 Crest Root sets, so someone, if we have a Foreman, is gonna have to use something else. Kind of a side thing, but I'm gonna make a little... Oh, they have to be unnoted, for fuck's sake.
Okay, there we go. Godsword Blades. Just making another Ancient Godsword so we can eventually break that down into orbs. We don't need them anymore. And we would rather just get Elder Orbs out of that, or Elder Components, Elite Components, whatever. Just so we can break those down, and then we can eventually repair a Torva set when we get another pair of legs. There's gonna be a world boost in 2 days from now. It's been announced. It's a bunch of drop rate, and we wanna focus on necks again. Yay, more necks! So that will be fun. And if we can get a pair of legs, we can use a normal Torva set, for example, to AFK on Flubber at Hellhounds. I don't think Crest Torva is necessary there, but it's all we have to restore shit. So getting death would be pretty good as well. Who's gonna buy a little currency with the sacred tokens and check out if we have enough for some more runecoin exchanges? Because I'm basically just waiting for Ty to finish his Slayer task so I can get the Borg with recharges and stuff so I can AFK some Mithril Dragons. Just for a bit. And then when, in about an hour or so, I'm gonna stream a little Chasmquaker on his account while he's using my account, and I'll AFK on Flubber on the side. Just a bit more fun to stream that than it is to stream Mithril Dragons. I don't like streaming AFK content in general, it's just super boring to me. In comparison, like, I don't mind doing a bit more chill stuff occasionally, but, you know, Chasmquaker is a lot more useful, more hype drops, could get executioner orbs, blah blah blah, that kind of stuff, right? So that's more fun in my opinion to do. Gonna see how much rune coins we can get from all of this real quick. Flubber just got a fucking Fang of the Beast again. That's number 5 in total for the group Ironman. What the flying fuck? How? Literally, how is that possible? 2200-ish KC. Can't see the end there. What the fuck? Oh, there's one easy exchange. I'm not sure if I'll make a second, but I'll try. Ooh, another little Eternal Crystal from the inbox from the daily. Alright, and another exchange. We're just stacking up rune coins for fun. Why the fuck not? Let's check out the total stack right now. And I think Time might have some more as well. And this is already gonna bring us to 355k. Now, he actually has 14,000 rune coins worth of holy branches. Can't trade those. So he could just put those on himself and exchange that. And we got a little Borg right here. We will be able to add two recharges and the unyieldings. We do waste a lot of money trading these around, but honestly, it's easily worth it because we get so fucking much more than we use. Like, buy a landslide.